Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Earlier we had discussed the first part of Surah Al-Naba along with its tafsir, and inshallah ta'ala in this video we'll be discussing the second half of the same surah. Verily, the day of decision is a fixed time, the day when the trumpets will be blown and you shall come forth in crowds, and heaven shall be opened, it will become as gates. And the mountains shall be moved away from their places, and they will be as if they were a mirage. Truly, hell is a place of ambush, dwelling place for the taqoon. They will abide therein ahqab. Nothing cool shall they taste therein, nor any drink, except hameem and ghasaq, an exact recompense according to their evil crimes. For verily, they used not to look for a reckoning, but they denied our ayah Hidaba and all things we have recorded in a book. So taste you, no increase shall we give you except in torment. So Allah says, verily, the day of decision is a fixed time. And Allah says about the day of decision, and it is the day of judgment, that is at a fixed time with a set appointment. Its time cannot be added or decreased. No one knows about the exact time except the Supreme Almighty Allah. This is as Allah says in Surah 11, Ayah 104, and we delay it only for a fixed time. And Allah informs, the day when the trumpet will be blown and you shall come forth in crowds. The Mujahid said, groups after groups. And Ibn Jarir radhiallahu ta'ala anhu said, this means that each nation will come with its messenger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and the heaven shall be opened and it will become as gates, which means paths or routes for the descending of the angels. And the mountains shall be moved away from their places, and they will be as if they were a mirage. And Allah says, as if they were a mirage, which means they appear to one who looks at them as if they were something, but they are actually nothing. After this, they will be completely removed. Nothing will be seen of them, and there will be neither base nor terrace of them. Then Allah says, truly, hell is a place of ambush, meaning it is waiting in preparation for the tawun. Now, taghuns are the disobedient rejectors who oppose the messengers. A dwelling place meaning a place of return, final destination, final outcome and residence. And Allah said, they will abide there in ahqab. Ahqab is a time period which is a plural of huqb, and huqb is the period of time. Khalid bin Madan said, this ayah and the ayah except your Lord wills, in ayah 11107, both refer to the people of Tawheed. And Ibn Jarir recorded this statement from Salim that he heard Al-Hasan being asked about Allah's statement. And in reference to Ahqab, it has no specific time or amount of time other than its general meaning of eternity in the hellfire. So Allah says that they will abide there in Ahqab. That means the wrongdoers will abide in the hellfire for eternity. Now, Ahqab is the plural of the word hukm. And hukm is equivalent to 70 years, and every day of it is like 1000 years according to the reckoning in this life, that is life on earth. So Allah's statement, Allah further says, nothing cool shall they taste therein, nor any drink, which means will not find any coolness in hell for their heart, nor any good drink for them to partake of. But Allah says, except Hameem and Ghasaq. Abu al-Aliya said, the Hameem has been made an exception to the coolness, and Ghasaq is the exception to the drink. This has also been said by Arabi bin Anas radhiallahu ta'ala anhu. In reference to the Hameem, it is the heat that has reached to its maximum temperature and point of boiling. And what is Ghasaq? Ghasaq is gathered from the sweat. tears and wounds of the people of hellfire. It is unbearably cold with an intolerable stench. So Allah continues to say that an exact recompense, which means that which will happen to them of this punishment, is in accordance with their wicked deeds which they were doing in this life, that is life on earth. Then Allah further says, for verily they used not to look for a reckoning, meaning they did not believe that there would be an abode in which they would be taken to account, but they denied our ayah khitaba, meaning they used to deny the evidence of Allah and his proofs for his creation which he revealed to his messengers. So they met these proofs with rejections and abstinence. Allah's statement regarding khitaba, it means rejection and is considered a verbal noun that does not come from a verb. Moving further, Allah said, and all things we have recorded in a book, which means surely we know the deeds of all the creatures and we have written these deeds for them. We will reward them based upon this. If their deeds were good, then their reward will be good, and if their deeds were evil, then their reward will be evil. Allah further goes on to say, to taste you, no increase shall we give you except in torment. Now this means that it will be said to the people of the hellfire, taste that which you were in. We will never increase you in anything except torment according to its type of sin and something else similar to it. Now Qatada reported from Abu Ayyub al-Azdi, who reported from Abdullah bin Amr, that he said, may Allah be pleased with them all, Allah did not reveal any ayah against the people of the hellfire worse than this ayah, that so taste you, no increase shall we give you except in torment. Then he said, they will continue increasing in torment forever. So this was the tafsir of Surah Naba from ayah 17 to 30. Now let's move further to ayah 31. Allah says, verily those who have taqwa, there will be a success, hadaiq and vineyards, and qawa'ib athrab, and a cup of dihaq. No laghaw shall they hear therein nor lying, rewarded from your Lord with a sufficient gift. Allah informs about the happy people and what he has prepared for them of esteem and eternal pleasure. Allah says, verily for those who have taqwa, there will be a success. Ibn Abbas and Ad-Dahab both said, a place of enjoyable recreation. And Mujahid and Qatada both said, they are successful and thus they are saved from the hellfire. The most obvious meaning here is the statement of Ibn Abbas, because Allah after this says hadaiq, and hadaiq are gardens of palm trees and other things, and vineyards and qawa'ib athrab, meaning wide-eyed maidens with fully developed breast. Moving further, concerning Allah's statement, and a cup of diha, Ibn Abbas continuously filled. Remarks said pure. Mujahid, Al-Hasan, Qatada and Ibn Zayd all said, this means completely filled. Allah be pleased with them all. Then Allah says, no laghaw shall they hear therein nor lying. Allah says, rewarded from your Lord with a sufficient gift, meaning this that we have mentioned to you is what Allah will reward them with, and they will be given it by his favor and from him. It will be a kindness, mercy, gift and recompense from him. It will be sufficient, suitable, comprehensive and abundant. The Arabs say, he gave me and he sufficed me. Now this means that he sufficiently provided for me, and from this a saying comes that Allah is sufficient for me. Further, Allah says in ayah 37, The Lord of the heavens and the earth, and whatsoever is in between them, the most gracious, with whom they cannot dare to speak. The day that Ar-Ruh and the angels will stand forth in rows, they will not speak except him whom Ar-Rahman allows, and he will speak what is right. That is the true day. So whosoever wills, let him seek a place with his Lord. Verily, we have warned you of a near torment, the day when man will see that which his hands have sent forth, and the disbeliever will say, "Woe to me, would that I were dust." So the Lord of the heavens and the earth, and whatsoever is in between them, the most gracious Allah informs of his magnificence, his majesty, and that he is the Lord of the heavens and the earth, and whatever is in between them. He explains that he is the most gracious, whose mercy covers all things. Then he says, with whom they cannot dare to speak. Now this means that no one is able to begin addressing Allah except by Allah's permission. And Allah says, except with whom Ar-Rahman allows. That is similar to Allah's statement in Surah 11, Ayah 107, on the day when it comes, no person shall speak except by his leave. This is similar to what has been confirmed in Sahih, that the Prophet said, and none will speak on the day except the messenger. And Allah said, and he will speak what is right, meaning the truth. And from the truth is the fact that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah. This is as Abu Saleh and Ikramah both said in reference to Allah's statement. That is the true day, meaning it will come to pass and there is no avoiding in it. So whosoever wills, let him seek a place with his Lord, meaning a place of return, a path that leads to him, Allah, and a way that he may pass by to get him, the Almighty. Allah says, verily, we have warned you of a near torment, meaning the day of judgment. And it is mentioned here to emphasize the fact that its occurrence has become close, because everything that is coming will certainly come to pass. The day when man will see that which his hands have sent forth, meaning all of his deeds will be presented to him, the good and the bad, and the old and the new. This is a similar to Allah's statement in Ayah 49 of Surah 18, and they will find all that they did placed before them. It is also similar to his statement, on the day man will be informed of what he sent forward and what he left behind. This is the Ayah 13 of Surah 75. Then Allah says, and the disbelievers will say, woe to me, would that I were dust. Now this Ayah, it means that the disbeliever on the day will wish that he had only been a dust in this worldly life. He will wish that he had not been created and that he had never come into existence. This will be when he sees the torment of Allah and he looks at his wicked deeds that will be written down against him by the noble righteous scribes among angels. It has been said that he will only wish for that when Allah passes judgment between all the animals that were in the worldly life. He will rectify matters between them with his just wisdom that does not wrong anyone. Even the hornless sheep will be allowed to avenge itself against the sheep with horns. Then when the judgment between them is finished, he, Allah, will say to them, that is the animals, be dust. So they will all become dust. Upon witnessing this, the disbeliever will say, would that I were dust, meaning I wish I was an animal so that I would be returned to dust. Something of similar meaning to this has been reported in the well-known hadith about the soul. There are also narrations recorded from Abu Huraira, Abdullah bin Amr and other concerning this. Allah be pleased with them all. So friends, this is the end of the tafsir of Surah Al-Naba, and all praise and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the giver of success and the protection from the error. Friends, please let us know in the comment section which is the next surah would you want us to give the tafsir of. And until we meet next, Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.